Hello students, and welcome to the quick solution of All India Cast Test Series JEE Main 2019 Test 10 Code A and B Physics. Let's move to question number 1. Question number 1. Two bodies are thrown from the same point, one straight upwards and the other at an angle theta with the horizontal. The initial speed of the first body is V0 and they are always at same height. Separation between the bodies when they are at the maximum height will be. So let's analyze the situation first. One ball is projected vertically upward in this direction with a velocity V0 and the other ball at the same position is projected in this direction let with a velocity V dash and it makes an angle theta with the horizontal. It is given in the question that the balls are at the same height and the instant when they reach their maximum height, you have to calculate what is the separation between them. So let this is the moment when they reach the maximum height. So if it is projected with the velocity V0, then the time taken to reach this height is V0 by G. And at this moment, the second ball is at this position. And the distance covered by this ball at this moment, X is equal to, that is Vx, that is V dash into cos theta into this time, that is V0 by G. Now we have to find out what is the value of V dash. It is given in the question. Since both the ball always at the same vertical height, so we can say that the initial vertical component V dash sine theta must be equal to V0. So I can find out the value of V dash. So it is V0 by sine theta. So it comes out to be V0 cot theta into V0 by G. So option 4 is the correct answer. Let's move to question number. In question number 2, a particle moves with a constant speed 10 meter per second along a parabolic path y is equal to x square. Radius of curvature of path followed by particle at x equal to 0 will be. So we know that the radius of curvature is given by v square divided by the normal component of acceleration at this instant. So that is an or ac. Now the equation of the path is y is equal to x square. So if I differentiate with respect to time, then vy is equal to 2x into vx. On further differentiation, ay comes out to be 2 into vx square plus 2x into ax. So at this moment, when the particle is at x equal to 0 and it is moving along this path y is equal to x square, then the velocity is in this direction and normal component of the acceleration is ay. So I have to find out what is the value of ay at this instant. The ax is 0 at this moment. So ay comes out to be 2 into vx. So the velocity at this moment is 10 whole square. So this is the value of ay. So the radius of curvature can be written as v square, that is 100, divided by normal acceleration, that is 200. So it comes out to be 0.5. meter. So option 2 is the correct answer. Let's move to question number 3. In question number 3, in the system shown, what will be the relative acceleration of 5 kg block with respect to 2 kg block just after the string is cut at point P? So immediately before when the spring is cut at point P, if I see what is the force acting on this 5 kg block, then due to the extension of the spring, its 5g is acting due to its own weight. And due to the extension in the spring, 1g is also acting in this direction. So at this moment, if I cut the spring, then this 2 kg block fall with an acceleration of g. So acceleration is g minus j cap. And the acceleration of 5 kg block at this instant is 6g by 5 minus j cap. So if I find out the relative acceleration of 5 kg block with respect to 2 kg block, then it comes out to be 6g by 5 minus g. So it comes out to be g by 5. So option 1 is the correct answer. Let's move to question number 4. In question number 4, a body with zero initial velocity slips from the top of an inclined plane forming an angle alpha with the horizontal. The coefficient of friction mu between the body and the plane increases with distance x from the top according to the law mu is equal to kx. Body will be having maximum velocity after traveling a distance of. We know that the acceleration of the block is given by g sin alpha minus mu g cos alpha. So the value of mu is kx into g cos alpha on the inclined plane. So at the moment when the velocity is maximum, the acceleration would be 0. So on solving this equation, 0 is equal to g sin alpha minus kx into g cos alpha. So the value of x comes out to be tan alpha by k. So option 2 is the correct answer. Let's move to question number 5. In question number 5, a chain PQ of length 3h is loaded in a smooth horizontal tube so that its length h and touches the surface of the table with end q. At a certain moment, the end p of the chain is set free. Velocity of end p when it slips out of the tube will be. So this is the situation at t equal to 0. Let at any time t, the length of the chain inside the tube is x. So at that moment, the force acting on the chain is h into lambda, that is the mass, into g, that is the gravitational force acting on the chain. This is equal to mass of the chain which is inside the tube plus the mass of the hanging part of the chain. So that is x plus h into lambda, that is the mass, into acceleration, that is v dv by dx. So if I solve this differential equation, then h into g dx divided by x plus h is equal to v dv. So at t equal to 0, when v is 0, the length of the chain inside the tube is 2h. So the value of x is equal to 2h. And at the moment when the velocity is v, then the value of x becomes 0. So if I solve this equation and solve for v, the value of v comes out to be under root 2gh ln 3. So option 1 is the correct answer. Let's move to question number 6.